Imagine a paper cut causing bleeding that just won't stop, where even a microscopic injury can become a life-threatening situation. For most of us, this will never be a problem. Everyday injuries are silently healed by our pre-programmed defense systems. But what if something goes wrong in that coating? For those with haemophilia B, this is reality. That's probably what you're thinking. Well, what if there was a way to reprogram those broken genes? Let's delve into the world of gene therapy to find out just how scientists are doing this. Welcome to the genetic basis of stuff and things. Gene therapy was first conceptualized in 1972 and made its mark in medical history with its first successful application in 1990 on a child with severe combined immunodeficiency. Since then, there have been advancements in gene therapy technology, expanding it to other diseases such as haemophilia B. Haemophiliacs have mutations in the genes encoding clotting proteins, meaning that they are unable to clot when they are injured, causing prolonged bleeding. This requires them to receive frequent prophylaxis to replace these proteins and can be very taxing on the patient. But how exactly does the clotting process work? The intrinsic pathway of coagulation is a crucial process for stopping bleeding. It starts when damage to blood vessels triggers coagulation proteins. These proteins then activate each other in a cascade, where factor 12 is activated first, then factor 11, then factor 9. Factor 9 helps convert factor 10 into a form that can produce prothrombin, a precursor to blood clots. However, in people with severe haemophilia B, a mutation in the F9 gene impairs the production of factor 9. Haemophilia B is X-linked, meaning that it is most common in males. The most frequent mutations causing severe haemophilia B are missense, nonsense, and splice site mutations near or in the F9 gene. Using their knowledge of the F9 gene, Amit Nathwani and his colleagues set out to study the application of gene therapy in haemophilia B in 2011 by exploiting an adeno-associated virus as a method for gene transfer. In doing so, their study represents the first breakthrough in the treatment of haemophilia B. But what exactly is an adeno-associated virus, and why is it so important in gene therapy? Adeno-associated viruses are non-pathogenic viruses belonging to the parvovirus family, and are the most widely used gene therapy vector. Its single-stranded DNA genome contains only three genes, rep for replication, cap for its capsid, and ap for assembly. These genes are surrounded by inverted terminal repeats that denote what would be packaged and translated into proteins, and what forms the viral backbone. Recombinant AAVs have been engineered to replace the viral rep and cap genes with a transgene between the ITRs and a cell-specific promoter so that the gene is only expressed in target cells. Once the virus has entered the cell's nucleus, its DNA persists as a circular episome, allowing its gene to be transcribed and translated into the encoded protein. Antibodies against the viral vector proves as a major challenge for AAV gene therapy. If the recipient already has antibodies against the adeno-associated virus, it could potentially negate the therapeutic effects of the vector. Nathwani's study disqualified patients with mid to high levels of these antibodies, leaving room for future studies to improve upon their findings. Following Nathwani's study, phase 1 and 2 trials were done by Wolfgang Miesbach and Dr. Stephen Pipe's teams to assess the safety of a single intravenous dose of an adeno-associated virus. This vector expressed a codon-optimized wild-type human factor 9 gene. They found that the therapy was well-tolerated and clinically effective, resulting in sustained increases in factor 9 activity, significant reductions in bleeding rates, and caused no severe side effects. Using this data, Dr. Stephen Pipe and his team launched phase 3 trials in 2018 for etranacogene dezaparvovec, or Hemgenix, to treat haemophilia B using gene therapy regardless of AAV neutralizing antibodies. The study included 54 adult males aged 19 to 75, all with moderate to severe haemophilia B. The researchers knew that their vector would be partially neutralized by the immune system, so they opted to insert a hyperactive variant of the F9 gene. The gene originated in Padua, Italy, where it was first identified due to its association with excess clotting and pulmonary embolisms caused by overactive factor 9. They then infused the vector carrying the Padua gene into their participants, and the results were nothing short of revolutionary. The researchers' primary discovery was that the patient's annualized bleeding episodes per year dropped from 4.19 to 1.51 post-treatment, and that the treatment worked regardless of AAV neutralizing antibodies. A reduction in bleeding frequency was also observed. 63% of participants experienced zero bleeding episodes post-treatment, up from 26% before Hemgenix. Additionally, the average number of necessary infusions per patient decreased by over 96%, from 72.5 per year to just 2.5. 52 of the 54 participants stopped prophylaxis entirely as Hemgenix increased and maintained their factor 9 so well that it pushed them into an almost non-haemophilic range, essentially curing their disease. Hemgenix significantly improves upon previous research like Nathwani's study, which was important but limited to men with low antibody titers and achieved only about 11% of normal factor 9 levels. In contrast, Hemgenix raised levels to around 39%, close to the non-haemophilic level of 40%. As we continue to break barriers in gene therapy, the question remains, what genetic disease is next? Thank you for watching, and we'll catch you next time.